naalala nyo ba sila? Para sa mga batang 90s dyan, siguradong naaalala nyo pa ang singing-proof na Smoky Mountain na binuo ng ating National Artist for Music, Mr. Ryan Cayabyab. Isa sa mga lead singers ng grupo ay si Geneva Cruz, na nakilala lalo dahil sa kanyang sikat na awiting anak ng Pasig at kabilang sa kilalang Cruz clan ng Philippine showbiz. Kaya naman through the years, nasubaybayan natin ang kanyang buhay from being a singer and performer to being a mom and a wife. Her stories of heartaches and her journey to finding strength to love again. Lahat ng kabanata ng kanyang buhay ay kanyang ibinahagi, kaya naman lahat tayo ay bumilib sa kanyang katapangan. Pero sa kanyang pag-alis sa limelight ng ilang taon at pagtira muna sa Amerika, hindi alam ng marami ang kanyang mabibigat na pinagdadaanan. Lalo na't hanggang ngayon, she still looks fit and fabulous. Sa kanyang pagbabalik sa Pilipinas, ibabahagi niya sa atin ang kanyang mga pinagdaanan at paano na ibalik ang kanyang self-love. Alamin natin dito mismo mula kay Miss Geneva Cruz, dito lang sa I Feel You.
Kamustahan at kwentuhan with singer, actress, and one hot mama, Miss Geneva Cruz. Welcome to I Feel You.
Hi, Tony. Hi, everyone.
Hi, Miss Geneva. Nasaan ka ngayon? Are you in the Philippines?
Oo. Dito na ulit ako.
Gaano katagal na?
Since Feb.
Oh, since halos nag
since February.
Nag-start yung pandemic. Ano yan, for good ka na?
Since bago mag-quarantine.
Yes.
Yes.
Ito ka na for good.
For good na.
Ano ka katagal nag-stay sa States bago ka umuwi dito sa Philippines?
6 years.
6 years. Nasaan si Heaven?
Oh, San Francisco. Heaven is in LA. I was 6 months pregnant when I moved to the States. Manganganak lang sana ako. Para kasama ko yung anak ko kasi just turned 18 doon, si Heaven during that time, and my mom was there. Pero my son needed me, so I extended for a few more years. So.
You have a new baby?
I do. She's not really a baby anymore, 6 years old. Her name is London. So I now have a boy. And
so you have an 18-year-old. And you have
a six-year-old.
Oh, okay, now I get it. Kasi nga, sinabi mo, 6 years ka nag-stay. When you went there, you were 6 years. Okay, now I'm calculating. How is it like to be a mother of two?
Interesting. They have a huge age gap, which is 18 years. So, pwede siyang parang maging anak na ni Heaven eh. So, mas nahirapan ako nung nanganak ako with London kasi syempre I was older, I was 38 and I was only 20 with Heaven. So dun pa lang nakita ko na okay, this is gonna be different because I'm older. Living in America, I had to do a 9-to-5 job. Walang yaya-yaya, unlike with Heaven before when he was a kid. But my mom was there, thankfully. So, mag-work ako ng 9-to-5 and then after nung work ko, ako na ulit kay London hanggang sa buong araw na gumising ulit ako and then same thing happens the next day. So, it was a different life, but I enjoyed it very much. It taught me a lot. It taught me to be a better mother.
How are you a better mother now compared to the old
I am more very hands-on. I'm very, very hands-on. I realized that if a mother, I mean, all mothers are not ready to be a mom, diba? I mean, sabihin nila, yeah, I'm ready. I have all the clothes so that when the baby comes out, it's like this. I read all the books and whatever, but all of us have different experiences. So case-to-case basis, hindi naman pwedeng puro libro lang. So yung experience, dahil iba-iba yung mga bata. I'm just more hands-on and mas attached si London sa akin. Like, hindi talaga siya mapakali when I'm not around. And attachment is good, but I'm also teaching her that she has to have this type of freedom as a child. Para hindi siya masyadong malungkot when I'm working.
Okay, you said you're a single mother of two. So I'm sure it's harder for a mother, for a mom of two na maging single, lalo na ngayon during this whole pandemic.
I guess it would be harder if I had no family who are loving and supportive, but I am grateful to have a supportive family and we're very, very close. So, syempre, I have a boyfriend. We've been dating for more than a year. He's really a good man, you know. And so I cannot say that women do not need men to be happy. I guess, yeah, we can all be happy, right? On our own, with our families, with our children. I want to be able to grow old with somebody.
Topic natin for this episode is self-love. And as we can see that you really are taking good care of yourself, never lost that drive and that goal na kailangan. You always look good, you look fit, you're always put together, hindi mo nakakalimutang alagaan yung sarili mo. Is that a constant like effort na kailangan kong alagaan ang sarili ko?
It has to be. It has to. You have to make a decision as a person, as a woman. It's a constant effort of commitment and dedication. You don't have to look hot or whatever. You just have to be able to love yourself truly and fully. Alam mo yung kahit mag-isa ka lang. Alam mo yung parang nanonood ka lang ng TV and you're like, oh, I'm enjoying my company. Pretty funny. And then parang, you know, you have to give yourselves a pats on the back, diba? Yung parang,
diba? Parang you have to celebrate yourself. You don't have to wait for anybody to celebrate you. You have to celebrate who you are already. Did you go through a depression?
Yes. You know what? When I was in the States, I realized that I did, but I didn't know. I lost a baby with my ex-husband when the baby was 6 months pregnant. And like, nawalan siya ng heartbeat one day. And I didn't know, but I think I have a feeling na after that happened, parang medyo nagkakaroon na kami ng problema, I think. And I wasn't aware, he wasn't aware that I was going through depression. But you know, now, I mean, it's water under the bridge, it's done. You know, you live, you learn, you make mistakes, and then it makes you make sure that you don't do those things again. And then the next time na parang merong depression, you at least should be open to talking to some professionals or your family members. Sometimes kasi you just want to be hugged or you just want to be heard.
Mm-hmm. You somebody to listen to you. Sometimes you
You don't even know that you're saving someone's life. That's why that's very important.
So your children make you happy. They are the ones who make you happy now. So you mentioned kanina you are in a relationship. You have a special someone right now in your life. What does he give you naman? This new relationship. What does this new relationship mean?
You know, it's a long-distance relationship. I was living in LA and he was living in the East Coast in Virginia. And he was one of my producers. That's why I met him. He was a Marine, you know, so sundalo. Merong ang kaibahan dito kasi alam mo yung tao na may sinabi siya, ginagawa niya. Yung merong paninintigan, may prinsipyo. Very important sa akin yung honest, yung hindi sasayangin yung oras mo. So, alam mo yung, that's what I need, yung lalaki na hindi pa macho, pero alam mo na, you know, he can also lead the way, you know what I mean? So, that's very important. Sarap minsan yung may kilig pa rin, di ba? Nakakatanda kasi masyado yung, ganun ka masyado na parang, it's okay to take care of your children. I mean, come on. But you have to take care of yourself. Make sure na yung mga kulang, parang kung nandiyan naman, and may na-meet ka, then yung romance nandiyan because it makes you feel good. makes you inspired, diba? So, yun yun.
For everything that you have been through in life, yung mga struggles, yung pain, yung journey mo, yung mga failed relationships, what's the best lesson that you have learned?
That you're enough. You're enough. It doesn't matter kung ano sabihin ng mga tao sa paligid mo, whether it be they're jealous or they just don't like you because they just don't like you. Lalo na sa show business, maraming ganyan. Tayo mo sabihin sa kanila na, I'm enough. I don't care if you don't like me.